Hello everyone, my name is Ali Akbar. Today we are going to discuss about kinematic chains, what are the types of kinematic chains, and most importantly, how can we determine whether the mechanism we have is a kinematic chain or not. So sit back, take a pen and paper, and enjoy. Let's get started. Now first thing first, let us see what is a kinematic chain. Kinematic chain is a combination of assembly of joints and links. A kinematic chain is a group of links either joined together or arranged in a manner that permits them to move relative to one another. In other words, when several links are movably connected together by joints, they are said to form a kinematic chain. For example, as we can see in this figure, all the links are arranged in such a manner that permits them to move relative to one another. Next thing that we are going to discuss is how many types of kinematic chains are there. There are basically two types of kinematic chain. First is closed loop kinematic chain. If every link in a chain is connected to at least two other links, the chain form one or more closed loops. This is a closed loop chain. As we can see in the figure, all the links are connected to at least two other links. For example, link 1 is connected to link 2 and link 5. Similarly, link 2 is connected to link 1 over here and link 3. Similarly, link 3 is connected to link 2 and link 4, and link 4 is connected to link 3 and link 5. Next thing, the kinematic chain is also classified as an open loop kinematic chain. A linkage failing to meet the closed loop criteria is an open loop kinematic chain. In this case, one or more of the links is connected to only one other link. As we can see in the figure of a joint arm robot, the hand or arm of a robot, which can be considered as one link, is connected to only one other link. As we can see, the hand of this robot is only connected at this point. That is, it is only connected with one of the link. Thus, we can say that this mechanism, this joint arm robot, can be termed as a open loop kinematic chain. This is just a practical example of a open loop kinematic chain. Now, moving forward, let's discuss how we can determine whether the mechanism we have is a kinematic chain or not. Earlier, we discussed that each link forms pair with two adjacent links. Thus, if each link is assumed to form two pair with two adjacent links, then the relation between the number of pair forming a kinematic chain and the number of link may be expressed in the form of an equation L equal to 2P minus 4, where L is number of links, P is number of pairs. Since in a kinematic chain, each link forms a part of two pair, therefore there will be as many links as the number of pairs. Another relation between the number of link and the number of joints which constitutes kinematic chain is given by the expression J equals to 3 by 2 L minus 2, where J is the number of joints present in the mechanism and L is the number of links that are present in our mechanism. These two equations, the equation 1 and 2, are applicable only to kinematic chains in which lower pairs are used. These equations may also be applied to kinematic chains in which higher pairs are used. In that case, each higher pair may be taken as equivalent to two lower pairs with an additional element or link. Now, let us apply the above equations to the following cases to determine whether each of them is a kinematic chain or not. These are just the two equations that we can use in order to determine whether a mechanism is a kinematic chain or not. Okay, So case 1, consider the arrangement of three links AB, BC and CA with pin joints at A, B and C as shown in figure. In this case there are three links, link 1, link 2 and link 3. How many pairs are there? AB and BC 1, BC and CA 2, and CA and AB 3. So there are 3 pairs and 3 links. And how many joints are there? Joint A, joint B and joint C. So there are 3 links, 3 pairs and 3 joints. Now in order to find whether this mechanism or whether this arrangement is a kinematic chain or not, we have to use these two following equations, this one and this one. So let's use it and put the values of links, pairs and joints into these two equations. First equation is L equals to 2P minus 4. Thus, if we substitute all the values in this equation, we get 3 equals to 2 times 3 minus 4, which is equals to 2. Thus, we can say that the left hand side of this equation is greater than the right hand side of this equation, right? Similarly, for the second equation, if we put the values of joints and link into this equation, we get the value 3 equals to 2.5, which says that the left hand side of this equation is basically greater than the right hand side of this equation. Since the arrangement of three links as shown in figure does not satisfy the equation 1 and 2 and the left hand side is greater than the right hand side, therefore it is not a kinematic chain and hence no relative motion is possible. Such type of chain is called locked chain and forms a rigid frame or structure which is used in bridges and trusses. Case 2. Consider the arrangement of four links AB, BC, CD and DA as shown in this figure. The number of links that are present in this arrangement are 4. How many pairs are there? AB to BC 1, BC to CD 2, CD to DA 3 and DA to AB 4. So there are basically 4 pairs. And how many joints are there? A, B, C and D. Thus there are 4 joints. Okay, so now substituting all the values of this arrangement into the following two equations, L equals to 2P minus 4. When we substitute these values in this equation, we get that the left hand side of this equation is equals to the right hand side of this equation. Similarly, when you substitute the values of joint and link to the second equation, we will find that the left hand side of the second equation is also equals to the right hand side of the second equation. Since the arrangement of four links as shown in the figure satisfies the equation 1 and 2, therefore it is a kinematic chain of 1 degree of freedom. Don't worry about the degree of freedom, we are going to discuss it in our next lecture. A little consideration will show that if a definite displacement, say theta, is given to link AD, keeping the link AB fixed, then the resulting displacement of the remaining two links BC and CD are also perfectly definite. Thus, we see that in a four-bar chain mechanism, the relative motion is completely constrained. Hence, it may be called as a constrained kinematic chain, and it is the basis of all machines. Case 3. Consider an arrangement of 5 links as shown in this figure. Thus, how many links are there? 5. Now, how many pairs are there? AB to BC 1, BC to CD 2, CD to DE 3, DE to EA 4 and EA to AB 5. So there are basically 5 pairs. And how many joints are there? A, B, C, D and E. So there are 5 joints. Now similarly, substituting all this value into the two given equation, which is used to determine whether this is of a kinematic chain or not. When we substitute the values in the first equation, we get that the left hand side of that equation is less than the right hand side of this equation. Similarly, when we substitute the value of joints and links to the second equation, what we get? We get that the left hand side of that equation is basically less than the right hand side of that equation. Since the arrangement of 5 links as shown in this figure does not satisfy the equations and left hand side is less than the right hand side, therefore it is not a kinematic chain. Such a type of chain is called an unconstrained chain, that is, the relative motion is not completely constrained. This type of chain is of little practical importance. Fourth and the last case that we are going to study is, consider an arrangement of six links as shown in figure. This chain is formed by adding two more links in such a way that these two links form a pair with the existing links as well as form themselves a pair in this case. Thus, how many links are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. How many pairs are there? AE to EF1, EF to FG2, BC to CD3, CD to DA4 and DA to AE5. So how many pairs are there? 5. And how many joints are there? A, B, C, D, E and F. So there are 7 joints. Thus, when we substitute all these values of these links, pairs and joints to the given equation, what we find? We find that the left hand side of that equation is equal to the right hand side of that equation. Similarly, when we substitute the values of joint and links to the second equation, what we find? We find that the left hand side of that equation is equal to the right hand side of that equation. Which means that since the arrangement of six links as shown in figure satisfies the equation, that is, left hand side is equal to the right hand side, therefore this arrangement can be considered as a kinematic chain. Most important thing is, a chain having more than 4 links is known as a compound kinematic chain. So this arrangement can be considered as a compound kinematic chain. I hope you all got what you were looking for. Thank you very much. If you have any doubts, please feel free to ask in the comment section, or you can also mail us on your email ID oatsinstitute@gmail.com. On our next lecture, we will discuss on degree of freedom and types of mechanisms that are present. Okay. If you liked our work, then please hit like and subscribe button below, and don't forget to share our lectures with your colleagues. Thank you. See you all in the next lecture. Till then, have a nice day. Bye-bye.